Hi, it's me again.
Today we're here at KTH, the Royal Institute of Technology, Kungliga Tekniska Högskolan in Stockholm, Sweden.
We both actually studied here for several years, so we have a bunch of memories from this place.
Let us show you around and give you a tour of this main campus located here on a map. Come.
To get to KTH Campus, as it's called, you can take the bus or subway to Tekniska Högskolan, or the tram to Stockholms Östra. KTH also has three additional campuses, KTH Kista, KTH Flemingsberg, and KTH Södertälje. Maybe we'll visit them too in future videos if you use that like button to show just how much you would want to see that.
While studying on campus, you'll never be too far away from food. There are plenty of restaurants and cafes close too, and even on the campus grounds. And for those who want to save some money, several buildings have microwave ovens where you can reheat your lunchbox that you brought from home. And when the weather is this good, you can then enjoy your lunch in the courtyard's green grass.
These main buildings surrounding the courtyard were built in the early 1900s, although the university's history goes back almost 100 years before that. The main campus is bigger than just these buildings though. If we take a look at this map, we can see that we're here now. And here is the entire campus. The dark blue buildings are KTH buildings. But as you can see, there are other colors on this map too. In green, we have student housing.
The housing is very limited, and the accommodation on campus is mainly for PhD students. But right outside campus, there are a couple of student apartments also.
In light blue, you can find other colleges that are also located on the KTH campus. The Swedish National Defense College, Försvarshögskolan. The University College of Opera, Operahögskolan. And the University of Dance and Circus, Dans- och Cirkushögskolan. The two later mentioned are a part of Stockholm University of the Arts, Stockholms konstnärliga högskola. And the names are no longer in use to clarify that they're actually the same college.
The white buildings on the map are startups or other small companies that can be found around campus. Often, these are founded by KTH students.
Going back to the buildings that actually belong to KTH, there's a 2,000 square meter gym available on campus. The gym is not free for all students, unfortunately, but it's nowadays run by the gym chain Nordic Wellness. So the quality should be comparable to other gyms in Stockholm.
And of course, there's a huge library that used to be boring and only contained books, but now has plenty of cozy study corners where you can get some quiet time. Looks like they're closed for summer though. I guess you're not allowed to study during summer break.
The furthest away you ever have to walk to get to class is the building M. Yeah, also, all buildings have their own letter, so you'll easily find your way to class. The students nowadays probably just take an electric scooter if they have to go to M, though. They don't know the struggles we had to go through.
No one home.
On another note, look at this beautiful hidden little garden right outside the principal's office.
Thank you so much for watching and joining us on this tour of KTH.
Hope you enjoyed the video and don't forget to like and subscribe for more content.
And hit that bell to get notified when we post the next video. Bye!
Bye!